Okay, now let's assume we're done working on this file and we want to open up a different company file. To do so, you simply go to File, Open or Restore a Company, choose Open a Company File, click Next, and when we click Next, what's going to happen is QuickBooks is going to close the current file so that it can open up the next file. One thing that's unique about QuickBooks is you can only have one file open at a time. It's not like Excel or Word where you can have multiple files open at the same time. QuickBooks only allows you to have one file open at a time. So right now QuickBooks is closing this file. It takes a while. And then it's going to ask us, well, now what file do we want to open? And while we're here, notice I'm in my original files folder. Notice it shows this set of files. Now I'm going to switch the view. Now I'm going to bring up Windows Explorer and show what's on my flash drive. So notice we are on my QuickBooks files folder, and inside that we are in the original files. And look, we have extra files. Let's look at chapter 1's files. We have 1, 2, 3, 4 files. The main one in green is our QuickBooks company file. Notice that's by far the largest. But we also have some additional files. We have a .nd and a .tlg file. Now the reason in the other view when we're in QuickBooks, I'm going to switch back to QuickBooks now. The reason we can't see all those extra files for chapter 1, see here's chapter 1, Chris and Raina, we only have one for Chris and Raina, is down here it says that this window is only going to show us QBW files, which is working, and QBA files, which are accountant's copies. So that's why this view from within QuickBooks shows fewer folders and files than our flash drive will show. So your next question is probably, well, what is this .nd and .tlg file? Again, I'm looking at my flash drive directly. I'm not looking at it from within QuickBooks. Let me switch back to QuickBooks. And I'm going to reopen up Chapter 1, Kristen Raina. After a moment, the file opens. Now let's see if we can find out what that .nd file is for. I want to introduce you to the help feature in QuickBooks. To use help, you click Help, QuickBooks Help, or you can just press the keyboard shortcut F1. Notice there's an F1 up here. These are shortcuts. I'm going to click Help, and I'm going to see if I can find out what that .nd file is for. Type .nd, and click on Search. What is an .nd file? You should get used to using QuickBooks Help. It's a good tool to learn how to use. So what is a .nd file? Our help feature tells us that these are configuration files that allow QuickBooks to access a company file in a network or multi-user environment. In other words, if you have multiple people using the same QuickBooks file at the same time. It also says that this configuration file exists while users are connected to a company file. Do not delete the file yourself. QuickBooks may not operate correctly if you manually delete this file. So we're going to leave that file alone. We're not going to touch it. We're not going to delete it. We're not going to use it. QuickBooks behind the scenes will create it for us. Now let's go find out what that other file is. I'm going to go back to my flash drive. Notice we have something called a .tlg file. If you're curious what that is, let's go look it up. I'm in my help feature back in QuickBooks. I'm going to type .tlg. And it says that it is a transaction log file. So now this window pops open and we have our explanation what our TLG file is. It's a transaction log. Okay, what is this file for? Let's say you only back up your QuickBooks file weekly. Halfway through the next week, let's say something happens to your QuickBooks file and becomes corrupted. Now you can go back and restore your last QuickBooks backup file, but you are now missing the transactions since you last backed up that file. So now what QuickBooks Data Services can do for you is they can take your TLG file, which are all the transactions since your last backup, and they can merge it with your last backup file. And then voila, your QuickBooks file is now back up to date. I'm going to switch back now to our view of all of our files. And the main reason I showed you all this is not so that you memorize what the .nd file is and the .tlg file is, but I want you to get used to using the help feature in QuickBooks. And I also want you to know that these extra files are there for a reason. Do not just delete them. And you also cannot open up these files. The reason you know you can't open up these files is because when we go back into QuickBooks and we try to open up a file, oops, I have to close my help windows. When I go to open up a file, it's not going to give us the chance to open up that .tlg and the .nd file. So as you can see in our Open a Company window, they are not listed. And again, the reason they are not listed is because down here, this is telling us that we're only going to see the QBW and the QBA files.